Alright, so, let me read this. Got this question from a friend in Australia, and he's working with someone on an ACL repair. Not real sure how long ago it was, but having some hamstring cramping issues when their speed and intensity is really high. And I sent him back a little answer on some things that I would be working on with this person if they were here. So if you've had an ACL repair and it's been a while, and around here where I live, the things that tend to be most neglected after someone has had an ACL repair through their rehab is getting them back up to speed through all the planes of motion. So if you can see this, this is number one. And some of the biggest correlations in ACL injury and then re-injury in the United States anyway are things like, and these are correlative, you know, I can't predict that if I fix this stuff you won't have an ACL tear, but foot collapse, ankle collapse, valgus knee, poor control of the trunk and hip, those tend to be some of the biggest indicators. Yeah, there's some other stuff too, but particularly when I have worked with an athlete who has had an ACL repair, has gone to rehab, and then they're like, I'm still having this or that, or the other thing going on, when I get a hold of them, these are the things that they tend to still be bad at. Foot, ankle, knee, hip, trunk control, through all the planes of motion. And a lot of times they can't even squat without cups in their foot still, or overextending the trunk, or any of those kinds of things, let alone jump and land well. It's almost like those things aren't covered in their rehab, or they're not covered very well. So that's where we spend a lot of our time, is getting back to, you know, slowly working to recovering your ability to do these things well through all the planes. And we start kind of sagittal plane stuff, squatting, deadlifting, single leg stance work, and then move into more dynamic things. I'll get into that in a sec. And then down here, eccentric hamstring strength and control, typically they're still quite weak back there. So get into things like stiff legged deadlifts, regular deadlifts, Nordic hamstring curls, become extremely important pieces of recovering fully and getting ready to return to play. And this last one is big. Where am I? Right here. Removing fear of movement. Let me zoom in on that. That becomes a big component. You have to get that person ready to tackle sport again without being scared that something's going to happen to their knee. And that, a lot of times, can be the biggest hurdle to overcome with someone. But going back up to here, so see my feet, hopefully. Just very basic and straightforward. You want to make sure with the people we're working with that, number one, if they're standing there, they can create a solid base, stable arch foot, and we don't see a lot of this going on as they're just standing there, the feet turned way out, and the foot collapsed, and the knee is inside the foot. Now, I don't know if you're going to get hurt there, but what I do know is if you're coming down from a rebound and you're going to plant your foot like this and you need to go that way, the forces are not favorable for this knee. So many times that's where we see those non-contact injuries, this open foot stance with a collapsed arch. The hip can't control the knee. The hamstrings aren't able to decelerate the force. And we have this twist and shear valgus across and a tear. So number one is just making sure they're standing like in their athletic stance. Can they keep their toes planted and their feet arch up? Can they just stand there and do that? Can I bring their feet together and they can do that? Can they get out wide and we can do that? Then can we get them here, keep those feet arched, and can we get them into a quarter squat or even just a ready position? We don't need to think about squatting all the way down right now. Can they just get here so that they can have options to move and turn? And then let's worry about, you know, can we get them to squat deep and keep that position? They open their feet a little bit, keep them arched up, sit down that position, because you're not always going to be in the best position to do things. Can they get on one foot balance, keep that foot arched up, bend a little bit, move, produce force to the other side. You know, even if at first we're just keeping that foot arched up and Cossack squatting, get that foot arched up and just working them side to side, and then we can get into, you know, getting on that one foot. Doesn't have to be big, but just, can you move over here and land under control? And then we get into some bigger jumps. Can you bring that foot behind you? You know, all those things. As far as our lunging goes, can I get that foot out in front of them? Keep it arched up, plant, turn, produce force from there. You have to bring all of that stuff back into their routine. And then as far as those other things go, just make, and we'll just kind of start from top down with the kettlebell, just making sure, can they be in that position and hinge and come back up. When I say hinge, I mean, you know, that knee, foot, and ankle, everything's staying in line, that butt's going back, and everything's staying right here, and they're getting a lot of activation through this part of the hamstring. We're not going out into a big squat shape. It's right here. Can they hinge, control that? They do it with a little bit of bent knee. Can they do it with, you know, one foot and one hand? Yeah, the Nordic hamstring curl. You can look that up. I'm not set up to do that here, but it is a very effective way to develop powerful eccentric strength in the hamstring, which is a lot of what they really need to come back. So I hope this helped him out when I sent to him, and if any of you other people are working with athletes that have had this kind of stuff happen to them and they're out of rehab and they're back in your gym and you need to kind of have a plan for what to do with them to get them back up to speed, or even if this ACL injury was years ago but they're having some issues pop up, number one is that trunk control. Make sure they can do that in all planes. Keep that ribcage over the pelvis, turn, hinge, squat. Because anytime they're getting into extension, they're not going to have as much power through the hip and control through the hip and hamstring. So, some stuff to think about. If you like this, give it a thumbs up. Stay for the credits for what else I'm doing. Check you later.